There's certainly a bit of a stigma with looking for intelligent life elsewhere in the universe. My name is Jason Wright. I'm a professor of astronomy and astrophysics at the Pennsylvania State University. I'm also the director of the Penn State Extraterrestrial Intelligence Center. There are a lot of corners of science that are very speculative and might not pan out, but when you say you're searching for extraterrestrial life, people think of science fiction. And so because of that resonance, I think the search for extraterrestrial intelligence often doesn't get taken as seriously as those other highly speculative kinds of science do.
I don't see why the study of extra dimensions, for example, is considered part of the mainstream of theoretical physics these days, while the search for intelligent civilizations is not. I think it's inappropriate. I think it should be changed. My name is Avi Loeb, and I'm a professor of science at Harvard University, chair of the astronomy department at Harvard.
When Avi Loeb suggested that this interstellar asteroid or comet that came through the solar system might be some sort of alien spacecraft or probe, some people reacted really badly to that, and other people thought it was great.
But you know, if it was alien, we probably would have had it before 7:50 in the show.
The most negative things that I've seen on Twitter and elsewhere are from people that haven't read the paper, which demonstrates how much prejudice there is on this subject. So we should not have a prejudice, we should not base our reaction to the possible existence of a civilization out there on emotions. We should just collect data and evidence.
I think a lot of people would be surprised to learn how little work actually happens in the search for extraterrestrial intelligence. It sometimes gets pushed to the fringes of respectable science, but the real problem is the lack of federal funding. That was certainly the case with US senators who canceled all NASA funding for the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, and they grandstanded and talked about Martian hunting at the taxpayers' expense.
The amendment I am offering today will eliminate funding for what I believe to be a foolish and wasteful NASA program, the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, or SETI.
The National Academies of Sciences produces a document outlining where efforts should be spent over the next 10 years. And so I've been part of a group of people who would like to work on the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, to write a series of those papers, arguing that it should be part of the national science portfolio. In the very first paper on this topic by Coconi and Morrison, they said that the probability of success that we'll actually find something is hard to determine, but the probability if we don't look is zero.
You know, one in four stars have an Earth-sized planet in the habitable zone. And so, you know, that opens the door for searching for life on those planets.
It just seems obvious that we should be spending more time thinking about the problem and actually looking for evidence of technological life elsewhere in the galaxy.
So my approach is based on modesty. I call it cosmic modesty. But given that there are more planets like the Earth than there are grains of sand on all the beaches on Earth, in my view, you know, it's quite likely that we are not alone.